Students, today I will show you how to make double stained permanent slides. Double staining means staining the material with two different stains. Usually in double staining, saffronin and light green are used. Instead of light green, we can also use aniline blue or fast green. Saffronin stains the thick-walled lignified cells such as xylem, sclerenchyma, etc., whereas light green stains the thin-walled living cells such as parenchyma, colenchyma, etc. Now, all of you come nearer to my table, I will show you how to make double-stained permanent slides. The materials you require for this experiment are what we have here on this table. Plant material for section cutting, one razor blade, two brushes, one petri plate with water, saffron in solution, another petri plate with water, 30% alcohol, 50% alcohol, 70% alcohol, 90% alcohol, 100% alcohol, light green solution, clove oil, Canada balsam, two needles, cover slips, slides, and one microscope for observing the section. So, we have all the necessary materials with us for taking the sections and making double stained permanent slides. First of all, you have to hold the plant material in your left hand with your two fingers, that is thumb and index finger. Bring your middle finger in support to the index finger. You have to keep the ring finger just below the material. This ring finger will help you in taking the material upwards when you are taking the sections. Hold the razor blade in your right hand in this way. Move the blade over the material from one end to the other. Now, you have the section over the blade. Like that, you have to take a series of sections. Now, all the sections are on the blade now. Keep the blade in water and shake it gently. All the sections have come into water now. Select a thin section out of it with the help of a brush. And transfer it to saffronin solution. In saffronin solution, you have to keep the section for 3 to 5 minutes. So, we have a minimum of 3 minutes time now. Do you have any doubts?
What do we use for preserving the material, sir?
The material is usually preserved in this type of bottles. For preserving the material, you can use acetic alcohol or 4% formaldehyde. Acetic alcohol means it is a mixture of acetic acid and alcohol in 1:3 ratio. Now, you take the section from saffronin with the help of the brush and wash it in water. After washing it in water, transfer the section to 30% alcohol. In 30% alcohol also, you have to keep the section for 3 to 5 minutes.
How do you prepare the saffronin solution, sir?
Saffronin solution is a 1% solution. It is usually prepared by dissolving 1 gram of saffronin powder in 100 ml of water. It can also be prepared by dissolving 1 gram of saffronin powder in 30% alcohol. When you dissolve the safranin powder in 30% alcohol, you can take this action directly from safranin to 50% alcohol. After 3 to 5 minutes, you take this action out of it and transfer it to 50% alcohol. In 50% alcohol also, you have to keep this action for 3 to 5 minutes. After that time, you take this action out of it and transfer it to 70% alcohol. In 70% alcohol also, you have to keep this action for 3 to 5 minutes.
Why do we use the alcohol grate, sir?
Alcohol grates are used to remove water from the sections. This process is called dehydration. When the sections are totally free from water, there will not be any bacterial or fungal contamination. After that time, you take the section out of it with the help of the brush and transfer it to 90% alcohol. In 90% alcohol also, you have to keep the section for 3 to 5 minutes. After that time, you take the section out of it and transfer it to 100% alcohol. In 100% alcohol also, you have to keep the section for 3 to 5 minutes.
So, why do we use so many alcohol grades? Why can't we directly use 100% alcohol?
If we take the section from safranin directly to 100% alcohol, the section will shrink and all the cells will lose their shape. So, you cannot see the cells in their proper order. Remember, you have to keep all the alcohol grates closed when you are doing all this. Now, I will ask you a question. What will happen if we don't cover the alcohol grates? No. One of you should answer. Santoshamma, can you answer?
To prevent the alcohol from the evaporation, they should be kept closed, sir.
Shirin, can you explain the loss caused due to the evaporation of alcohol?
Yes, sir. Alcohol evaporates faster than water. So, when alcohol evaporates, the percentage in each grate will be reduced. For example, 50% alcohol may become 40%, 30% alcohol may become 20%, and so on.
It's good. I am really happy that you know it. Now, take the section from 100% alcohol with the help of the fresh brush and transfer it to light green solution. In light green solution, you have to keep the section for half minute to 1 minute.
Sir, is light green solution also a 1% solution in 30% alcohol?
The answer is both yes and no. It is yes because it is 1% solution. It is no because it is not dissolved in 30% alcohol, but it is dissolved in clove oil with little absolute alcohol for clarity. After that time, take the section out of it and transfer it to clove oil. Until you mount the section in Canada balsam, you can keep the section in clove oil.
Sir, why do we use clove oil?
Clove oil is a clearing agent. It removes the excess of light green solution. Now, you take a slide, wipe it with the help of a cloth, and take one drop of Canada balsam and put it over the slide. Now, you take the section with the help of a needle. And put the section over Canada balsam. Now you take a cover slip and put it over that with the help of a needle. You have to see that there should not be any air bubbles inside. Now you have a double stained permanent slide. This can last for 5 to 6 years. Now you take the section and observe it under the microscope. One by one, you can come and see the section. We have used petri dishes and watch glasses for double staining and preparation of permanent slides. Instead of watch glasses and petri dishes, we can also use this type of porcelain staining sets. This will reduce the amount of consumption of alcohol. Now, I will once again explain you the important steps involved in double staining and preparation of permanent slides. First of all, you have to cut the sections of the given material. Select thin sections out of them. Stain the thin sections in saffronin for 3 to 5 minutes. After that, wash the sections with water. Then dehydrate the sections with 30% alcohol, 50% alcohol, 70% alcohol, 90% alcohol, and 100% alcohol. In each alcohol grade, you have to keep the sections for 3 to 5 minutes. After the dehydration process, stain the section with light green for half minute to 1 minute. After washing the section with clove oil, you can mount it in Canada balsam. Now, all of you can go to your seats. Mr. Chenchuramaya will give you the plant material. You can start preparing the double stained permanent slides. Thank you.
ఇంప్లిమెంట్స్ మరొక పాఠం ప్రసారం అవుతుంది.
The glow of life which nature kindles is seen everywhere, even on the wayside. Man is a child of nature and is dependent upon her bounty for his survival, as other forms of life are. Nature has richly endowed Andhra Pradesh for growing food for both animals and humans. Her gift is seen in the clusters of trees with luxuriant foliage, thickly grown hedges, and smiling fields covered with green stalks gaily swaying. Andhra Pradesh is blessed with river waters, across which dams have been built to create reservoirs. In addition to water, it has rich, fertile soil, nature's own inputs in agriculture. In Andhra Pradesh, the tillage operations, that is breaking, loosening, and pulverizing of the soil, are widely done with the traditional bullock-drawn wooden country plow. Iron mold board plows and the tractor-drawn scientifically designed plows are also used in certain parts. The country plow is made of locally available wood of Acacia arabica. It consists of four parts: the handle, the body to which a share made of cast iron is attached, and a beam or sharp pole. The country plow is also used for a variety of other operations, such as sowing of seeds, harvesting of some crops, intercultivation, etc. A smaller type of the country plow, which can be easily drawn by bullocks, is used for wetland plowing. There is another kind of plow known as moldboard plow or iron plow. Besides a handle, it has a moldboard and a share on one side, and a landslide and a frog on the other. The beam is tied to the yoke with a rope to hold it in position. The share cuts the soil, which is lifted, pulverized, and inverted by the mold board before being thrown sideways. Rectangular furrows are formed when the moldboard plow is used, but the soil in between the rows does not remain unplowed as it does when the country plow is used. The iron plow, unlike the country plow, is not suitable for use under all conditions. In fact, it is most effective only under the optimum soil moisture condition. The tractor-drawn iron plow has two or three moldboard plows mounted on a frame and manipulated by the tractor operator as demanded by the soil condition. The disc plow is a tractor-drawn plow widely used for dry soils. It comprises two round concave discs which revolve around an axle and a furrow wheel which moves in the furrows in plowing. Its discs cut furrow slices and the soil is thrown out. for loosening the soil and breaking up the soil clods, the blade harrows or disc harrows are used. The blade harrow has a handle, a 4- or 8-sided rectangular body, two tines fixed on either side to which a blade made of iron is fixed. This is the beam of the blade harrow. It loosens and breaks up the soil and uproots many kinds of weeds. There has been in use the animal-drawn disc harrow also, with 2 sets each of 3 discs mounted on an axle. It has a beam attached to the yoke and a seat for the operator. During the harrowing operation, the discs revolve together with the axles. The tractor-drawn disc harrow, on the other hand, has 2 sets of discs fitted one behind the other, facing each other. When in operation, it throws the soil sideways in both directions, which helps in loosening it thoroughly. In addition to the implements presented, there are some agricultural implements which are used for specialized operations. For instance, the seeds of some plants are sown on one side of the ridges which have to be formed. For the formation of such ridges and furrows, a special implement called the ridge plow is used. It resembles the moldboard plow, except that the former has 2 moldboards, one on either side, instead of 1 as in the latter. The distance between the 2 moldboards can be adjusted with the help of 2 metallic pieces fixed behind them. The 2 moldboards are attached to a common share. For the supply of water needed for irrigation can also be necessary. For the formation of canals, an implement called bun former is used. The important parts of the bun former are 2 moldboards on either side fixed in an angular way. The front end of each of these moldboards opens outwards while the rear one closes. In addition, some hand-operated implements are used for the removal of weeds in the fields used for crops. When the crop is grown in rows, a special tractor-drawn implement called a cultivator is used for intercultivation. This implement helps in loosening the soil, breaking up the soil clods and the surface encrustation. The cultivator has several tines attached to the frame. At the end of each tine, there is a shovel. But for intercultivation in wetland rice fields, a special hand-operated implement called rotary or paddy weeder is used. The weeder has 2 weeding rows with tines. When in operation, as the weeding rows revolve, the weeds are either uprooted or covered with mud. To puddle the soil in wetlands, a special implement called wetland puddler is used. It consists of puddling units with angular bladed hubs rotating on the axle. Yet another special implement used for leveling is the leveler. It has a rectangular wooden body with small iron spikes fixed to its bottom. As its very name suggests, it is used for leveling a plot of land for the purpose of maintaining a uniform level of standing water needed for rice cultivation in wetlands. Andhra Pradesh presents an interesting profile of agriculture, growing a variety of food and cash crops in abundance. There can be no more heartwarming sight than that of a field covered with sunflowers. Andhra Pradesh grows millets for the sturdy and jowar for the hardy, castor seed and the juicy, delicious mangoes, which are on the menu of both the rich and the poor. The most ubiquitous scenario in Andhra Pradesh features a lush rice field, harvesting, winnowing and storing of grain, making it the granary of South India.